every morning. Beginning the day right is very important. Today we find plenty of reasons to complain in life. Because first of all, situation is difficult. On top of it, we don't have right answers to the present challenge. Even the rules are changing every day. So we find lot of reasons to complain about. We are not able to meet our family. Even there, our mind complains. Some people have not met their children since so many days. So we have reasons to complain. These days we even complain about God. We complain about life. But by complaining, our inner battery here keeps discharging. It keeps going down. When this mental battery keeps going down, it will affect our body. And our state of mind affects everyone around us. On our family and our patients. So we cannot afford to complain. Let's teach our mind a different language of gratitude. Instead of thinking that we have not met our family since so many days, we need to start saying that I am safe. My family is safe. How grateful should I be? So what if I have not yet met them? We are safe, they are safe. Your children are safe. How can we thank God enough for that? If we teach our mind to be grateful, it will not complain and it will not be sad. It will start seeing the same scene with a different perspective. So let's begin every day with gratitude. The very first thought will be of gratitude to God. With the second thought, thank your mind and body. So thankful that our mind and body are healthy. And then gratitude to your family. Gratitude to all your colleagues at hospital. Gratitude to nature. There is so much to be grateful for. If we give gratitude as the first thing in the morning, we will not feel like complaining during the day. Because language of the mind would have changed. So we will give gratitude every morning. Thereafter, we will start using the language of our elevated thoughts. Which means a vocabulary of high energy words. Positive, pure, powerful affirmations. High energy words. Let's take 10 thoughts. On top of it, you can add any other thought that you want. But today, let's just take 10 basic thoughts. For the next 10 days, we will take those 10 thoughts. We will repeat it multiple times every day, taking it as a homework. And they will be thoughts of how we want to be. Just remember one equation always. Sankalp se siddhi, which means our thoughts manifest. Whatever thoughts we create, they manifest into reality. Thoughts manifest. Thoughts become a reality. Life is a manifestation of our thoughts. Whatever we think of, becomes a reality. At this time we need to do only one thing. We just need to think right. If we start thinking right, our destiny will automatically be right. We will start with 10 thoughts in the morning. The first thought is, I am a powerful being. Second thought is, I am a peaceful being. Why should we create these two thoughts? First thought is, I am a powerful being. Powerful being means my state of mind is elevated. Situation cannot overpower me. Other people's behavior cannot overpower me. Regardless of what people say and do, I don't get disturbed. Because I am a powerful being. Other people's energies cannot touch me. I am a powerful being. Second thought is, I am a peaceful being. Which means throughout the day, no anger. No irritation. No getting irritated while talking to people. We cannot afford it at this time because our soul battery will go down. And the other person with whom we get angry or irritated, we don't know what state of mind he is dealing with. At this time the minds around us are in pain. Scolding them will not be right karma for us. People can make mistakes. We will discipline them. But we cannot scold them, especially at this time. All the scolding is not right at any time. Scolding someone at this time becomes very risky. Because right now the other person has very little power to tolerate scoldings. People's power to tolerate has come down. So the message needs to be conveyed. Being assertive, with discipline and a lot of love. Not with anger and irritation. So first thought is, I am a powerful being. Second thought is, I am a peaceful being. Our third thought will be, I am a fearless being. You are fearless and that's the reason you go to hospital every day. But we need to create this thought. So that the fear present in people around us should never overpower us. Not just today but for the next 1 or 2 months. Right now people are scared even though they are at home. So when we start going out, there will be fear. Looking at each other, people start creating fear. They can get very conscious about the physical distance to maintain when working with colleagues. Lot of things are going to change in the mind. So fear will increase in the society. Every day we need to create this thought. I am fearless. Our fourth thought will be, my body is healthy. And will always be. My body is perfect and healthy. And will always be. Why are we creating this thought? What if I get infected? This should not be a thought even in our dreams. This thought should not even be present on the mind. Because this thought is harmful to both our mind and body. It's not safe for our mind and body. So we need to erase that thought. To erase it, we need to create another thought on top of it. What will that thought be? My body is perfect and healthy. And will always be. My body is perfectly healthy and will always be. Our fifth thought will be, it's very important. It is as important as wearing a mask. God's power is an energy circle all around me. It is protective shield. Just like mask is our protection. Similarly God's powers are my protection. God's power and blessings is a circle of white light around me. I am protected. I am protected by God's energy. Our sixth thought is, nothing can enter into the circle. Which means nobody's thoughts can enter this protective shield. Nobody's behavior can enter. Nobody's wrong words can enter. Nothing can enter. You will not get disturbed looking at people's behavior. Because you have created a protective shield all around you. I am powerful. I am peaceful. I am fearless. My body is healthy is fifth thought. I am protected by God's power and blessings is sixth thought. Draw the same circle of God's protection around your family. Don't create a single thought on your mind as, what if it happens to my family? Our thoughts manifest. We will create thoughts only of the reality which we want. We will not think or speak of anything that we don't want in reality. We will only think of what we want the reality to be. Don't think or speak of whatever you don't want, should happen. So visualize God's protective shield surrounding your family members. My family is safe. Seventh thought is, God's power and blessings are a protective shield around my hospital. Just visualize this every morning. Energy circle of God's white light around your hospital. Everyone is safe. And then the circle of God's power and blessings surrounding the entire planet. Look at the planet like this. And encircle it with God's powers and blessings. My planet is safe. Other people are saying the world is not safe. We will not talk that way. We will say, my world is safe. That thing which was traveling this planet. Many people are predicting about how long it is going to stay. Speculating when we will get a treatment for a vaccine. They say it takes 6 months, 1 year or longer. These are accurate statistics. But what is their basis? The basis for these statistics is today's condition. Nobody is sure when we will have a vaccine. But we calculate statistics. They are logical statistics based on today's condition. But if our vibrations rise, if people's minds become powerful, if everyone starts meditating, praying, and blessing each other, statistics will change. Miracles get created. All of us collectively need to create miracles now. Instead of thinking and speaking of those statistics, start saying that thing which had come on the planet is finished. It's gone, never to come again. People who have the role of calculating statistics, they will play that role. It's not our role to worry about statistics. Our role is to elevate our state of mind in order to finish those statistics. All of you might have experienced, when you are sitting with someone at home or hospital, if you are upset about that other person, if you just create a thought, when will this person leave? They are sitting here for so long. You don't say anything but just create a thought in your mind. Please leave. I am getting bored. Please get up and leave right now. Within 5 minutes that person will get up and get going. Even if you tell them, why are you leaving? Sit down for some more time. They will make an excuse that they have some other urgent work, and leave. Why did they leave? They received your vibrations of asking them to leave. If we think, it looks like he will sit here for another half an hour. He will not leave any sooner. Maybe he will be here for one more hour at least. Then that person will stay for one more hour. It is the power of vibrations on other people's minds. So for that thing, we will not even take its name in our affirmation. We will say, that thing which had come, has gone forever. Never ever to come again. And our last thought for our affirmation is, I am God's angel. God has chosen me to bestow happiness on everyone. God uses me to give happiness and health to all. 10 thoughts. I am powerful. I am peaceful. I am fearless. My body is healthy. God's powers around me are a circle of protection. Nothing can enter into this circle. God's power and blessings around my family. They are safe. God's power and blessings around my hospital. God's power and blessings around the world. That thing which had come on the planet is gone forever. Never to come back. And 10th thought is, I am God's angel. God uses me to give happiness and health to all. To repeat these 10 thoughts in your mind, it takes only 10 seconds. It doesn't take longer than that. Every morning, just reaffirm these 10 thoughts. Just feel and visualize them. Take out 5 to 10 minutes for yourself. Repeat these 10 thoughts and feel them as deeply as you can. And then talk to God. It's time to have a personal conversation with God. Talk to God and tell Him everything that is happening in your hospital. Tell God about all your patients also. Tell God, I surrender to you. Use me today. Whatever is right for each patient, I should do only that right karma. So meditation should be the first thing in the morning. Next, when you are commuting to your hospital, or while returning from there, use these lines. At least 10 to 15 minutes of commute time will be there. Do spiritual study in those few minutes. Use your travel time for spiritual study, which means wisdom given by God to us through this activity. What goes into the mind early morning? Purity, divinity and power. We will not fill the mind with what is happening in the world. We will fill it with whatever God teaches us. Whatever goes inside will become our thoughts. Whatever will be our thoughts, they become our reality. So this is about beginning our day right. Gratitude, affirmations, meditation and spiritual study for a few minutes. During the day, after every 1 hour, we will pause only for 10 seconds. This is not difficult for you to take out 10 seconds. I need to repeat those 10 thoughts. Why repeat them? For it to become my state of mind. And for other quality of thoughts get finished. 10 seconds after every 1 hour. And then, 10 minutes before you go to bed at night. Spiritual study is very important. Information you consume before sleeping at night. When high energy words enter your mind before you sleep at night. For those 5 to 6 hours while you are asleep. Your state of mind and the vibrations that radiate from your mind to your body will be very pure, powerful, and divine. Thinking about any problem before going to bed or arguing with someone should never happen. Mind should be completely slowed down just before you sleep. Then not just our body, even the mind will sleep. For the mind to sleep, it has to slow down before sleeping. 10 or 15 minutes before sleeping, read a spiritual message. And repeat those 10 thoughts as last thoughts before going to sleep. So once in the morning, once after every hour, and once before bedtime. One last thing to take care is diet. Right now all of us might be having a vegetarian diet. Doctors are suggesting that we take an alkaline diet. Certainly we need an alkaline diet. Also the vibrations of our food needs to be very high at this time. If anyone is eating non-vegetarian food, experiment with vegetarian diet for the next 3 months. As is the food, so will be the mind. The food we eat is not only about nutrients for the body. It not only energizes the body. It is vibration for the mind. We are what we eat. As is the food, so will be the mind. As is the water, so will be the words. We need to hold on to this power because we need to create miracles at this time. We need to tap into all kinds of powers because the mind needs to be empowered. As is the food, so will be the mind. As is the water, so will be the words. Which means vibrations of the food and vibrations of the water we drink have to be very pure. Today there is vibration of fear in the water in our city. There is fear even in the vegetables and fruits we buy. The one buying is scared, the one selling is scared. There is fear given in the fields, where they are all grown. So be rest assured, there is vibration of fear everywhere. Like how we don't eat anything without washing them. Similarly, we should not eat anything without changing its vibration. In the kitchen at your home, play songs of God's remembrance. Throughout the day, all 24 hours. At your office and your house, play songs of God's remembrance. Spiritual songs, bhajans or mantra, anything of your choice. Even if it is om chanting. It's a high energy word. Let it keep playing in the kitchen. Any high energy words that you like. Let it play in your kitchen throughout the day. Even if there is no one in the kitchen. Let those high energy words keep playing. Vibrations of the water, vegetables, and fruits in your kitchen will all change. This is how prasad is prepared. They are prepared while songs of God's remembrance are playing. When each and every word enters that food, it doesn't just remain as food. It becomes prasad. It gives comfort to the mind and health to the body. And this is exactly what you want right now, isn't it? So high energy words need to play in your kitchen. If you cook food at home, pay attention. Think of God while cooking. Repeat those 10 thoughts while cooking. Before eating every meal, remember God. Repeat those 10 thoughts before you eat. Just repeat those 10 thoughts before your every meal. Before drinking water, if we think of God just before drinking water. We were actually taught to do it since childhood. We were taught to give gratitude to God before eating or drinking. We energize everything. Everything we consume should be energized. Either these 10 thoughts or any other high energy words that you choose. You can choose anything. Whatever you want happening in reality, create a high energy thought for it. Before every meal, think of God and repeat those thoughts. Even before drinking water, you can repeat those thoughts. Before drinking tea, coffee, or milk also, you can repeat those thoughts. So before any food enters your body, you would have changed its energy. When energy of the food is changed before it enters your body, the energy of your mind will change. And when energy here changes, your destiny will change. Our thoughts create our destiny. Our thoughts manifest. Everyone is creating their own destiny. So don't think the way everyone else is thinking right now. Elevate your thoughts and create miracles in your life. Your role is so beautiful that if you create miracles in your life, you will become instruments of creating miracles in other people's lives. When your mind remains peaceful and powerful just by you entering the room, patient's mind will get empowered. Right now you cannot go close to the patient. You cannot touch a patient. All protective gear is worn. So even the procedure of healing has changed. But your vibrations are not blocked by the protection gear that you are wearing. Patient may not be able to see you or your smile. But your vibrations cannot be blocked by the protective gear you are wearing. So we will heal them with our vibrations. So these 10 thoughts in the morning, once after every hour. Before eating and drinking anything. And before going to bed at night. Spiritual study for 15 minutes every morning. And for 10 minutes before sleeping at night. And meditation where you create a beautiful relationship with God. If you do all this even for just 10 days. For 10 days if you repeat these thoughts, at these set times. Within 10 days you will find your state of mind very different and vibrating very high. You will feel completely different. When you feel different, your destiny will change. Be certain about one thing. You have plenty of blessings. You have accumulated plenty of blessings because of your karmas. Even if everyone around you is scared, you should not fear. Because nothing can harm you. You have God's powers and people's blessings. And today everyone's prayers are with you. Have complete faith. Create miracles in your life. Be God's angels and give health and happiness to everyone. We will sit in silence for a minute now. And end this video in silence. Before that, let's repeat those thoughts once again. As you listen to those thoughts, repeat it in your mind. Feel and visualize the thought. I am a powerful being. Situation and people's behaviors, whatever is happening around me, it will not affect me. I am a powerful being. I am a peaceful being. No matter what the situation is, my interactions and my behavior remains peaceful. I am fearless. My body is healthy. And will always be. I am healthy and will always be. God's protective shield of powers and blessings surrounds me completely. God's power and blessings is a circle of protection around me. Nothing can enter inside this circle. This is my protective shield. God's power and blessings is a circle of protection around my family. My family is safe. God's blessings and powers is a circle of protection around my hospital. Each one is safe, powerful, and healthy. God's blessings and powers is a circle of protection around the planet. Look at God's healing energy. White light around the planet. I am God's angel. God uses me to give comfort and health to everyone. It is my fortune. Gratitude to God and to my fortune. Give gratitude.